Welcome, Andreas, to today's Engineer's Kitchen session. Efficient engineering is one of the most important issues for COPA-DATA. Also product development. You, as one of our solution experts, can you show us some details what we mean with that?
Yeah, sure. I brought a zenon project with me where I can show you how efficient you can do engineering in zenon. So you see in this project, we have some dashboards. So for different locations, you have different zenon screens where you can see the values of the variables.
I could imagine it would be a lot of work.
Yeah, if you don't use the efficient ways in zenon, it would be a lot of work. You would have to have four screens at least, four screens with functions, a lot of variables. You have to link each variable to each of the elements. And this you have to do for each screen. So it's really a lot of work if you don't use the efficiency mechanisms of zenon. Mm-hmm. But in this project, I'll show you how it's done in the editor. Mm-hmm. You will see there's only one screen for the dashboard.
So this is showing all the five different cities and data for it. Only with one screen.
So you need only one screen.
You make once the layout and once the design.
You do it once, mm-hmm. and you can use it for all of the dashboards. Maybe you'll say, okay, you'll probably do it with substitution, right?
Yeah.
You know our substitution at the screen switch function.
Yes, this would be my preferred way.
Then you would have to have four or five screen switch function on this screen. Now I'll show you there's only one screen switch function that leads to this dashboard. So I'll show you how it's done. If you open the function, you get to the dialog where you can substitute the variables and also the functions.
Okay, so the blue ones here are representing the functions of the screen we want to open.
Right.
And we can substitute both. We can substitute the functions and the variables of a screen.
Right. So you can have a rule, define it up here, and say, okay, I want to substitute Salzburg mm-hmm. with another city.
So it's pure text-based then?
It's pure text-based, mm-hmm. and but as you can see, this is not used in this project, because if we do it this way, we would have to have a screen switch function for every location. Okay. So there is an even more efficient way. We use the replace indices tab over here, mm-hmm. and just say we have the indexing rules, replace Salzburg by param. And param is a parameter that comes from a dynamic element.
Okay.
So down here you see the preview of the replacement. Salzburg gets replaced by the parameter.
So I guess it makes sense to make up your mind at the very beginning about the naming conventions of variables and this kind of stuff.
Right,
so
right.
This works, of course, perfectly if you have structured variable names with a kind of meaningful syntax and not variable one or variable two.
Right, right. If you work with numbers, it's also possible if you do it in the right way, but if you have a meaningful way, it's the best. Mm-hmm. So what's the dynamic element where the parameter comes from? I'll show you. It's the button where the function is called. Mm-hmm. So if I go to Munich and look at the parameters of this button, we have the section where the function is called. And here we have our screen switch function.
Mm-hmm.
And down here we have the parameter that is then substituted in the function.
So I define something directly at the position where the function is executed. And
right.
This information is then transformed into the
so
function.
So you call the same function every time, but with a different parameter.
Impressive.
And the function uses this word, in this case Munich, and substitute all variable from Salzburg
to Munich. Mm-hmm.
So if we want to have a new dashboard, we just have, we need the variables. So I already prepared a new location. I named it Tokyo.
Yeah.
So you also see I used structured data types for efficient engineering. I only have to create one structure variable and get all the variables I need. So I have already Tokyo. Now what I have to do is link the function, the screen switch function of the dashboard, enter the parameter, which is Tokyo, and I'll just give it a text also, so we can... We need to know where we are going to, and just reload the runtime. And now we should be able to navigate to Tokyo. You'll see, we have a new location, Tokyo, in our project.
Andreas, that was perfect. I'm pretty impressed with how less effort we can enhance an existing zenon project, also with a hot reload in that system. As a small thank you, I want to hand over you one of these nice t-shirts.
Oh, thank you very much.
Looking forward to see you soon again in maybe one of the next sessions of the COPA-DATA Engineer's Kitchen.
Sure.
What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.